Hello, my name is Raúl Morales Reséndiz and I work at CEMLA, the Regional Association of Latin American and Caribbean Central Banks. Together with my colleagues Milton Vega and Gregorio Abrazo from Central Bank of Peru and Anaí Rodríguez from CEMLA, we present this policy paper on payment aspects of financial inclusion in Latin America and the Caribbean, identifying progress, gaps, and opportunities. Last decade, in response to a G20 global call, the central banking community adopted a new task to support the health of financial systems, that is, to promote a fair and wide access to financial and payment services. Since then, financial inclusion has become an important objective for many emerging and developing economies' central banks. We believe that supporting inclusiveness in the financial and payment systems will certainly influence the central banking of the future, especially in times of disruptive financial technologies. Financial inclusion as a policy goal faces significant measurement challenges. This is explained, among other reasons, for having frail data and limited methodological tools. Notwithstanding, it's crucial to understand where the main gaps are and what opportunities they have, so central banks and other authorities can best contribute toward greater financial access. We propose a new way to measure financial inclusion gaps and opportunities. Our work uses the CPMI and World Bank framework named Payment Aspects of Financial Inclusion. We try to assess how effective can be a financial inclusion strategy from seven different angles, from legal to market issues, to key considerations on interoperable payment platforms and financial education as well. We develop an econometric logic model controlling by countries and the PAFI framework with data from 9 countries of the region, resulting from a unique self-assessment methodology that we also suggest for this purpose. Our main contribution consists on how central banks can leverage the PAFI framework to self-assess their policy, regulatory, and operational actions to support financial inclusion strategies from a payment systems perspective. In our model, we find, for instance, that whenever central banks have less control on strategy roles and actions, and/or the implementation horizon is longer, it becomes challenging to achieve financial inclusion goals. Moreover, we also demonstrate that regulatory and technological challenges are the most significant barriers. As such, our work can be used by central bankers and other relevant authorities to identify factors of success or barriers that should be considered in the design, attuning, or deploying of a financial inclusion strategy. We hope that your work is of your interest. Thank you very much.